What's up, guys? What's going on? It's Dredd, and I'm back with another video. We're on Madden 23 today with the Indianapolis Colts. Clearly, they are looking for a new quarterback going into this next season. They're not going to be rolling with Matt Ryan, Sam Ehlinger, or Nick Foles. That was just a mess this year. We know they're going to be looking for something new, and Derek Carr needs a new spot. We could start looking at rookies and stuff like that. Stroud, Young, they may be the answer, but I don't know if the Colts are picking quite high enough. They're going to have to move up for one of those guys. Carr is going to be a lot more affordable, and we've seen them go that way before, going and getting the veteran guy. Carr is better than Matt Ryan. He's better than Carson Wentz. I still don't think he's the answer, but I think he's a better option than either of those guys were. I don't know if I think this happens necessarily. I think there's a good chance they're probably tired of the way their seasons have been going year after year. I think they may go out and get a young guy to try to develop him. But for today, we're going to put Derek Carr in there and see how it goes. He's going to be okay at quarterback. He's a little older, so we have to get this done quick. We can't leave him around too long. But he's got decent weapons. Jonathan Taylor and Michael Pittman are awesome. We could use another receiver. Alec Pierce, probably not going to get it done. But it's a good foundation there. We'll move up Jelani Woods. The offensive line is okay. We need Bernard Ryman to develop, and we need anyone else at guard. Actually, we're going to generate best lineup, see if anybody else is healthy. Doesn't look like we're going to have any luck with that. So let's see what we got on defense. Defense is obviously pretty nice. We got a lot of good players in the front seven. Actually, a lot of good players. I really like this front seven. Two good corners. Isaiah Rogers isn't terrible either. Julian Blackman, I liked him a lot. Kind of slowed down this year, but hopefully he can step it back up. The team's solid. We just need to get a few positions addressed. We're going to hop into the season, simulate the first year, see if we can make the playoffs. If we do, we'll try to play them. If we don't, we'll hop into the offseason and try to run it back. If you guys enjoy content like this, please drop a like and a sub. It does help me out a ton, and it makes doing these videos so much more fun. When I see everybody interacting and enjoying them, it just, you know, it's motivating. It's motivating. And if there's any other videos that you guys want to see, drop a comment. Let me know what you guys want to see. I'm here to try to make y'all happy, so let me know. We're going to simulate this first season. Let's see how it goes. So, year one is over, and we did, in fact, make the playoffs. 10-7 is a solid year. We'll take that. I feel like it's pretty attainable. I'm assuming Jonathan Taylor probably carried us. It looks like Carr did pretty well too. 32-11 touchdowns. That's not, or 32 touchdowns, 11 picks. That's not bad. We'll take that. Could use a higher completion percentage. Could use a few more yards, but it's not a bad year. Yeah, Jonathan Taylor carried 1,700 yards, 18 touchdowns. That's phenomenal. 5.8 yards per carry is ridiculous. Love to see it. 7 touchdowns added by Zach Moss is not bad either. Let's check the receiving stats. Alec Pierce actually led the team. That's good because he'll develop and he could maybe be a pretty significant playmaker for us in the playoffs here. 10 touchdowns, that's big. That's big. Only 4 for Michael Pittman. He really underperformed, honestly. I was hoping for more out of him. Leonard, of course, he leads the squad. A lot of good production on tackles. Let's see how the sacks look. This is where I want to see us shine. Again, I'd kind of hope for more out of this defensive line. That's a little disappointing. 7 interceptions for Rodney McLeod is awesome, though. We'll take that all day long. And kicking, never should have gotten rid of Hot Rod. That's just disappointing. That is just disappointing. We're gonna upgrade players. We're gonna hop into this first game. We'll see how it goes. All right, we are going to get into this first week against the Jacksonville Jaguars, division rivals. It should be a fun week. And whoa, we blow them out. Big time win. We blow them out. 42-21. We're going to upgrade players and get into the next. All right, now we got a tougher matchup going up against the 14-3 Ravens. Definitely going to be a rough game, but hopefully we can get it done. No way. We do. It's a much closer game, but we get it done. Another win, and Derek Carr has a chance to lead us into the Super Bowl. That's ridiculous. Very unexpected. We're going to upgrade players and get into one more game here. All right, Jonathan Taylor is up to a 98 overall. He's got to be the reason we're making this run right here. Hopefully, just one more, we get absolutely destroyed. A lot more like what I expected to have happen. I did not think that was going to be the year. It's going to be the Vikings versus the Bills in the Super Bowl. Interesting, interesting. We're going to hop into the offseason, try to fix the team up, see if we can make a little run back. It's definitely going to be tough, though. We gotta bring in some good talent, but hopefully we can make it happen. All right, so we needed some specific positions. I think that was pretty obvious. Right guard and tight end being two of the most prominent. We get a big-time high-upside tight end, a lot of athleticism there, and we get the best right guard in the class. Neither is going to be a huge improvement, but I'm happy with both. So hopefully we're able to make some more moves here. We're going to try a couple other guys, see if we can bring them in, see if those can be, see if they can be the answer to the team. All right, so we threw out a few more offers. We're going to bring in Matt Gay, needed a kicker. He's going to be our guy, Jarvis Landry, and Keanu Neal as well, a couple older vets to help out. It really isn't a very exciting free agency class, which is kind of disappointing considering how desperately we needed some guys. But we get the right guard. That's our key. I like bringing in Samualu. We just needed someone really bad there, and I don't know if he's going to be the answer, but he's going to help out a lot. We're going to try to go out, probably get a receiver in the draft, maybe a linebacker, and hopefully those can be the improvements we need to make a run here. I like our squad. We've got a lot of talent. I just don't know if it's quite enough to get us over the edge, but we're going to try to, and we're going to see if we can get it done. Starting the draft here, I don't even know what pick we're going to have. It's going to be late, though. Pick number 29. Hopefully one of the top receivers is still on the board at this point. Going to make our selection. I don't even know who that is that it just said went. Josh Downs is there. I like Downs. I like Downs a lot. I don't know if he's going to be the move, though. Jalin Hyatt, I like the speed. He's got some potential, just probably not quite what I'm thinking. I definitely just saw the guy we're going for. Ricks would be awesome. We're going to go for JSN, though. He was probably the most productive receiver last year, obviously. Definitely was held back by injuries, but we've got Pierce and Pittman for the outside. I feel like those guys in their size, they can stand out there. I know not necessarily where people would think they fit normally, but I like them out there. I like bringing in JSN for the slot. I think he can do a lot of work there for us. I still like Josh Downs. Darnell Washington is interesting as well. But I think Eli Ricks, if we fill out that cornerback room, we get him as our number two guy. We have him and Gilmore on the outside, Kenny Moore in the slot. I think that's a sick build on defense. We're going to make it happen. 6'2 is awesome size. I like that a lot. He's got the stats, at least the physical abilities. Let's check his skills. It's not going to show us much about his skills yet. I like him. I know I've drafted him before in other draft classes, and he was a baller. I don't know about this one in particular. So hopefully he's good for us. We'll see what we can make happen with him. I'm going to come back. I think we look at tight end or linebacker here. We need both. Dalton Kincaid might not be a bad idea. I like him. We might go Kincaid here. I do like that. I do like that. And I do like Jelani Woods, too, but I just don't want to wait for someone to... Interesting. I don't want to wait for someone like that to develop. I just want to be able to move forward with them now. I don't see any linebackers that I'm in love with. We're going to go take Kincaid. We're trying to build up this offense around Derek Carr. It's supposed to be a video about him. We want to make the most OP offense we can. That's not great. He's probably not going to do much playing for us, but that's going to be it for the draft. I just don't know who else we would really take at this point, but we're going to move forward. The Colts have a lot of draft picks from the Wentz trade. In real life, they're going to be able to make some moves with those. Their third, fourth, something like that in the draft order, somewhere up there. They're going to probably try to make a move up, maybe with the Bears to get someone like Stroud or Young. Personally, I'm not high on Levis. Anthony Richardson is just too much of a project for me, and the rest of the guys in the draft just aren't even worth considering, in my opinion. So I think they're going to make a move up, probably in real life. But for the sake of this rebuild, we're going to move forward with the squad we have. We're going to move forward with Derek Carr. Let's get into year number two. I'm going to set the lineup, and we're going to simulate. I'll see y'all at the playoffs. All right, and just like that, we are 5-12. That's just kind of how Madden goes. It's inconsistent, that's for sure. More production out of Carr, I guess worse completion percentage and one more interception. Not a great year. Jonathan Taylor way down, even with an improved offensive line and more weapons around him. JSN played really well, 1,100 yards and 5 touchdowns. Pretty much the same numbers from Pittman, Pierce, Kincaid, both decent. Defensively, I guess Buckner balled out. The rest of the defensive line sucked. No interceptions, hardly. Ricks had two. Our team's definitely better. It's much higher overall now. It just didn't play as well. That's unfortunate. I was really hopeful. That first season got me excited. It doesn't look like we're going to be able to get it done. If they do trade for Derek Carr, I don't think he's the answer anyways. So I'm not surprised at the outcome of this video. But either way, I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know your opinions on Derek Carr and where you think he's going to end up. How you think this would go? I'm sure Colts fans want something different. I don't doubt that. So I'm still curious to see what everyone has to say, though. Thank you for clicking on the video, y'all. I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace, guys.